Good evening, friends. Welcome to this masterclass one on introduction to derivatives. I am Nandish Shah, derivative analyst at HDFC Security, and I am joined by Mr. Devarsh Vakil. Welcome, Devarsh.
Hi.
So the my first question to you is, are derivatives popular in India?
Welcome to this webinar, friends. So let's talk about derivatives today. So as we can see, derivatives are becoming increasingly popular in India. Derivative markets are gaining significant popularity day by day. Since its introduction in 2005, we have seen that the popularity has grown manifold. Derivative volumes have grown almost 36% in last 10 years. The growth, compounded annual growth rate, is 36%. We had almost 5 years, 6 years back, the volumes were around 72,000, 1,25,000 crores. It has exploded. And now, after the introduction of weekly expiry, the option volumes have gone almost in 14 lakh, 15 lakh crore. So the derivative markets are gaining a lot of significance. It is becoming important. It is becoming essential tool for every investors, every traders to have in their repertoire. So it is important to learn about derivatives. It is important to understand derivatives. If you see in India's rank, NSE has become the global leader in index options. The stock future ranking of India in the world is number 3. So basically, derivatives not only are gaining acceptance in India, the Indian derivatives are becoming global leader. So it is important to understand derivatives.
Yes, derivative indeed a very popular product in India. So can you share some lights on what is derivatives?
Sure. So basically, derivatives are the product whose value is derived from the underlying assets. So we can have equity derivatives like stock futures, stock options, forex, commodities. It is the most traded asset class in the world. The volumes in commodities and in currency markets are multifold in other parts of the world compared to equity markets. It is gaining popularity in India. Indian commodity and currency derivatives are also gaining a lot of significance. And equity, after the entry of weekly expiries, are growing manifold. So there are basically two types of derivatives which are famous in India: futures and options. The number of stocks available in derivative segment right now are 143. It was around 2008, it used to be 250, but gradually illiquid stocks have been removed, and now we have 143 stocks available in derivative segments. So while you have about 2500 around stocks traded on Bombay Stock Exchange and around 1,000-1,500 stock actively traded on National Stock Exchange, derivatives are available in India in 143 stocks. So what are the advantages of derivative? And this is the most important point to understand, that suppose you buy equity, you can either have a one-sided view. Either you are bullish on a company or bearish on the company. If you are bullish on the company, you invest into that company, you buy the stock and hold. But you cannot express your negative view. If you are bearish on the company, if you think that this company has the stock prices is going to go down, if you think that the stock price is overvalued or this company is not going to survive, then there are no instruments available in the cash market with the help of which you can express your view. But derivative is, and the especially the stock derivatives are such a beautiful instrument. With the help of them, you can express your view in any direction. Either you are bullish, then also you have instruments available. If you are bearish, you have instruments available and strategies available. And if markets are likely to be sideways, that is, you are not expecting stock price to go up much or go down much, if you are not expecting volatility, you have instruments available in derivatives to express your view. So this is the key advantage of derivatives, where whatever is the kind of market, there are instruments which will help you express your view and earn profits. The four key advantages which we find of derivatives are higher leverage, higher liquidity, lower transaction cost, and hedging and risk management practices. I'm going to cover first three, the leverage, liquidity, and transaction cost now. The hedging and risk management will be covered in the long-term masterclass. So what is leverage? Basically, in derivatives, by paying a small amount, you can take a larger exposure. In derivatives, you only pay the margin to take the full exposure. Let us understand this by an example. Suppose you want to buy 1,000 shares of Reliance. Suppose Reliance stock price, for the sake of clarity and easiness to calculate, suppose it is rupees 1,000. So you want to buy 1,000 shares of Reliance at 1,000 rupees of share. So basically, you want to take exposure of rupees 10 lakh. Now, in cash markets, you have to go out and invest full 10 lakh rupees. But in derivatives, suppose you are looking at futures, the benefit is that you are getting leverage. You only pay a certain amount of margin. For sake of clarity, an example, let us say 20% is the margin. So you pay only 2 lakh rupees to get an exposure of 10 lakh rupees. And this is the key advantage in derivatives. It provides you leverage, and leverage can help you generate higher returns. Second important benefit of derivatives is the liquidity. Derivative contracts are normally quite liquid compared to cash markets. Usually, the stock futures are 2 to 3 times the more liquid than the cash market itself. Recently, when we studied Tata Steel or Reliance, we found that they are 3.5 to 4 times more liquid than Reliance Industries or Tata Steel's cash market volumes. So it has very low impact cost. If you want to buy large quantity, or if you want to liquidate large quantity, the derivatives market give you a lot of freedom compared to cash markets. The spreads are very thin, and it has liquid. And third important benefit which we find for derivatives is the transaction cost. We know that while we transact on the exchanges, we pay the brokerage and other charges. The government charges and the stamp duty all are dependent on the number of the amount of brokerage. The benefit of derivatives is that compared to cash market, usually the brokerage is relatively low here. And that's why you end up paying lesser charges. That means your cost is relatively low, and that increases your profit. So while it is liquid, it gives you benefit, it gives you advantage to express your views in both ways. The transaction costs are also lesser.
So there are many advantages of the derivatives. So now can you share some details about the basis of the derivative? I mean, what are the types of derivatives? And what are the products available in the derivatives?
Sure. So basically, there are two types of derivatives which are very famous in India. The first is futures, and other is the options. Let us go into them in little detail, one by one. The first is futures. So futures contracts is an agreement between two parties to buy and sell asset at a certain time in a future at a certain price. Now let me demystify this. So what are the basic terms and terminology of a futures contract? So there are basically four things which you need to understand futures. First is the spot price. Spot price, or is the cash price under which the underlying asset, who the futures are based on. So for example, in our example, let us say Reliance industry is the spot price. 1,000 rupees is the cash price of Reliance. We will call it the spot price. Now that is one market. In futures market, the futures of Reliance Industries will trade at a slight premium in usual market. So that price is considered the futures price of it. Every derivative contract has two basic features. One is the expiry date, and another is the contract size. So what is the expiry date? In India, usually for the monthly expiry, last Thursday of the month is the expiry date. So for example, when you are trading, you are using, say, March futures, the last Thursday of the March will be the expiry date of that futures. That those contracts will expire on that day, then either you have to square it off or you have to roll it out to the April month. So expiry date is a key terminology, key ingredient of any derivative contracts. You need to understand whether it is a March contract, whether it is an April contract, whether it is a long-term December contract. Once you have that understanding, it will able to help you decide which instrument to trade on. Now in cash market, you have flexibility to trade any shares you want. You can share one share, you can buy 10 shares, you can buy 1,000 shares, 10,000 shares. In derivatives, there is a called contract size. So every derivative contract is fixed as a number of shares available to trade in that contract. For example, in Nifty in India, the contract size has been kept at 75 from August 2015. So if you want to trade in Nifty, you have to buy 75 shares of Nifty, and that is called the lot size or the contract size of a futures contract. Similarly, for the Bank Nifty, the contract size is capped at 20. The regulator, SEBI, usually when they introduce a new contract, they try to keep the contract size around rupees 5 lakh. So when you compare any stock price and you usually divide the 5 lakh rupees by the number of share price, you will get the contract size. Contract size is easily available on all broking terminals. It is available on exchange website. So this is about the futures. Now, apart from the futures, future is just like equity, where you have unlimited risk and unlimited reward. Compared to futures, there are instruments which are very interesting and which give you limited downside and unlimited upside. These instruments are called options. So what are the options? Just like when you buy an insurance, you pay a certain premium to the insurance company and you get the insurance cover. Similarly, in options, you pay a certain premium and you get to have the unlimited upside using that options. So we have two kind of options available, the call option and the put option. So usually when you are bullish on the market, you want to participate in the upside of the instrument, you should use call options. If you are bearish on the market and if you want to participate on the downside of the stock price, usually you can participate by using the put options. So when you buy a call option or a put option, it basically you only pay the premium amount and you get to participate in the complete upside or downside using these instruments. So let us go into a little bit detail of call options. So call option buyer basically has the right but not the obligation to buy the given quantity of underlying asset at a given price before the futures date. So for example, I am bullish on Reliance. Reliance stock price is trading at 1,000 rupees. If I think that the Reliance is going to go to 1,100 rupees, then I have a choice that I can go out in the market and buy 1,000 strike price Reliance call option by paying certain premium. For example, let us say the premium is rupees 10. So by paying only 10 rupees, I get to participate in Reliance upside by buying the call option. Now, what if Reliance does not go up in that month? Then obviously I will lose my 10 rupees. So that is the maximum loss I can have in Reliance call option when I buy it. Similarly, when I buy a put option, I am trying to express my bearish view. So when I buy Reliance, say 1,000 rupees put option for say rupees 10, I can participate in the downside of Reliance Industries. For example, suppose Reliance were to go down from 1,000 rupees to 900 rupees, I will get to have the profit of 100 rupees by paying the 10 rupees premium. So options are an instrument which are very interesting. It gives you unlimited upside by paying only the premium price. So the terminology, which is important to understand in our option markets, like in futures, the price is important. The expiry date is also important. The important is the strike price. At what price I'm buying or selling the stock option, that is also very important. So after understanding futures and options, we need to understand what are the factors which basically affects the option price. So there are three, four important factors which one needs to study. First is the important is the underlying stock price. In case of, in our example, say Reliance Industries, the stock price of Reliance is the most single most important factor. Whether Reliance stock price goes up or goes down will determine the option pricing. The second is at which price I have decided to buy the option. That price, the strike price, is also the second most important factor. For example, if Reliance strike price, Reliance stock price is 1000 rupees, whether I am buying 1000 rupees call option, 1100 rupees call option will determine how the pricing moves. Similarly, when I am buying a put option, say whether Reliance 1000 rupees put option or Reliance 900 rupees put option will determine how option pricing evolves. As we studied earlier, the time of expiry, whether it is this week's expiry or the this month expiry, is also important to understand. Now, one more factor which determines the pricing of option is the volatility. If underlying stock is highly volatile, usually it leads to higher premiums. And if underlying stock price is not very volatile, then the option premium will be less. So the probability of stock moving 5% is, say, higher in this month. Usually it is high beta stock, then option prices are likely to be higher. And if stock is low beta, it is lowly, it's low volatile stock, then the option premium is likely to be less. Other two important factors which are minor in to understand are the interest rates and dividends. If there are dividends announced by the company, it also affects the derivative prices. So here is the table which gives us the complete picture on how which factors are affecting the option prices. So as I explained, if strike price is higher, for example, call prices will be higher. If time to expire is higher, the price of option premium will be higher. For example, 1000 rupees March call option will have a lower price compared to, say, 1000 rupees April expiry or 1000 rupees May expiry of Reliance Industries. Volatility and risk-free rate are also positively correlated to option prices. So these four or five factors, if you can master it, you will be able to master how option prices move. So this is what we wanted to cover in the first masterclass. Let us just recap. These are going to be a series of four masterclasses. We just want to introduce to the concept of derivatives in this class. So what we have covered the what are the derivatives. Derivatives are getting increasingly popular in India. They are getting 34% CAGR in India every year, and it is gaining popularity. It is a must understand. Every investor and trader must understand this tool. They should have that, master this tool. It will help you express your view, whether you are bullish, bearish, or the markets are sideways. You must understand derivatives. Then only you will be able to benefit from a sideways market or a bearish market. If you understand this tool, then it will help you express your view and profit from market volatility. And we have understood the concept of futures and options. In next class, we will try to go in detail and understand the finer intricacies of derivatives. Thank you all for joining for this webinar, and I hope to see you for the next class.
Thank you all for joining.
Have a good evening.